Hi guys, welcome to Tips Explain Workshop. So a few common approaches here. What the Explain is asking you to do is actually to use your knowledge, biological knowledge, to explain. So give the reason for example, the results. Give the reason for something that you can possibly see. So, for example, we've got the solution tested with purite turned purple because proteins were present. Okay, so remember that all enzymes are proteins, but not all proteins are enzymes. So, in this explanation here, why the purite turned purple, you need to say that because of proteins or peptide bonds were present in the solution. So if you were asked to explain the process that takes place in a specific part, for example, stick to this. So you won't get any marks for irrelevant answers. So for example, they could ask you to explain how ATP is produced in the mitochondria. So you don't need to write everything that you know about respiration. So think, amend the question. For example, in this situation, how ATP is produced in mitochondria, okay? So mitochondria here, it's your key word. So if they're asking about mitochondria, don't talk about glycolysis because that's not taking place in the mitochondria, okay? Here you're talking only about link reaction, Krebs cycle, and ETC. So where would be the ATP produced? Will be produced in Krebs cycle, little amounts, and a lot in ETC. Okay, so be specific and read questions properly. So let's have a look through a few scenarios. So we've got scenario number one with a little bit of approach of describe and explain. So here what you need to use is so what aspect. Okay, so you've got tracheal system. And you need to explain three ways in which an insect's tracheal system is adapted for efficient gas exchange. So in here, three ways. So you need to write three bullet points, write down three aspects of the tracheal system, and then say why is it important, backing up with your biological knowledge. So here, this so what approach. So for example, the aspect tracheal is have thin walls, so why is it then important? That provides the short diffusion pathway, okay? Or for example, the highly branched or large number of tracheoli, so that's the aspect. Why then is it important? So you're explaining, so they provide the large surface, okay? So there's a lot of this so what approach, so make sure you do it, okay? So a statement, so back up with biological knowledge. Right, scenario number two, knowledge and again, so what approach. So we've got the atrazine binds to proteins in the electron transfer chain in chloroplast of wheat, electron transfer chain, reducing the transfer of electrons down the chain. So I'm gonna do a narrow down, reducing. Explain how this reduces the rate of photosynthesis. So they already told you that it's reduced. What they're interested in is the fact that how this reduces the overall rate of photosynthesis. So think about ETC. What's the job of ETC? The job of ETC is to produce reduced NADP and ATP, and you're starting from there. So less ATP, so less reduced NADP, so less light independent reaction, for example, okay? And the first marking point refers to this process of ETC, so reduced hemiosmotic gradient or proton gradient and cross cycle-like membrane. So remember, the main aspect is electron transfer chain, what it is, what does it reduce, what were the products, and think about the effects of less amount of those products in the whole photosynthesis, naming the stages. So not general photosynthesis, light independent will be affected. Okay, so Question number three, scenario number three, using data. So you've got lots of data here, and you've got the question that 30,000 years ago, the mean number of stomata on the lower epidermis of pine tree leaves was much higher, okay, than it's today, and this would have enabled the plant to grow faster when the carbon dioxide concentration is low. So we've got carbon dioxide here as well. Explain why. So think what was given here. Grow carbon dioxide. What is carbon dioxide needed for? For, of course, photosynthesis. So they will have more carbon dioxide for photosynthesis. So you must show your knowledge in explain type questions. Scenario number four, then, it's using figures. So a snip tool here from our PowerPoint on the gas exchange, one question with the describe approach. We're using still the same figure, but this time the air moves into the lungs between times P and Q, okay? And explain how the diaphragm causes this, okay? So question before was to describe what happens between P and Q, and now explain how. So this is what happens. This is what you can see because you described this before, but now you need to back it up with biological knowledge, so more advanced stuff. So here we will again have this so what model answer. So diaphragm will move down or flatten. This then increase the volume and decrease pressure. So air moves from higher to lower pressure or down pressure gradient, okay? So remember, explain is to say why you can see such a stuff using biological knowledge. Scenario number five, using information, because normally you've got the question that starts with use the information provided to explain the results in table one, and those are your results, okay? So you've got number of offspring and you've got here a picture of the chromosomes. So explain the results in the genetic questions here. We of course need to be able to explain the results based on the ratio. So if that was a normal dihybrid cross, we would see the ratio 9 to 3 to 3 to 1, but it's not. Why is it not then? You need to think, right, because the genes are linked. So they will produce less of this specific phenotype and crossing over took place. Okay, so again, explain what you can see, explain the information, back it up with your knowledge. And the last scenario, almost, we've got number five, what if? So what if you know your process well, but they're asking you to find yourself in different situation? So we've got the inhibition of absorption, and explain how this will cause an increase in volume of urine produced. So how does inhibition, absorption of sodium and chloride, okay, in the filtrate produce will increase the volume. Increasing the volume means what? Will be more water. Okay, you can always amend questions. So so the water potential of filtrate will decrease. Why? You explaining this because that inhibits absorption, so the water potential will decrease, so water will not leave by osmosis, or less of water will leave by osmosis, and this is taking place in the collecting duct because this is where osmosis takes place. Okay, so again, highlight key things and add the words to the questions to help you out with working out the knowledge behind the question. Right, so scenario number six, linking aspects, so synopsis. So you've got here the image shows you glycogen granules in the skeletal muscle, and you need to explain the role in the skeletal muscle, right? So what's glycogen? It's a polymer, it's a storage material. What's the skeletal muscle? Of course, what will